Hello everyone, panicCoffee here. I have acquired new nippers since my last Hobby Nippers Showdown video, so I figured it's the perfect opportunity for another showdown. Will the Godhand keep its crown? Let's find out. But first, coffee.
Computer. Coffee for two.
So according to their description, the Zuron 2175 ET was specifically designed by a professional scale modeler. Now, from my personal experience using it, this Pro Cutter is a solid nipper with large blades and body that would be ample for cutting thicker sprues or gates. So if you have a sprue part that is rather large or thick, especially with clear parts that are harder than the conventional plastic. So the Zuron is what I use to spare my Godhand nippers and other more smaller nippers. However, it does not make the cleanest of cuts and it leaves a rough nub after. Up next, we have the Tamiya sharp pointed side cutters for plastic. This is the number 35. Of course, Tamiya probably doesn't need any introduction. They make amazingly detailed plastic model kits and tools for as long as I can remember. I've actually discovered them primarily when I was still into four-wheel drive mini RCs back in the day. I used to ogle and window shop a lot. This side cutter requires just minimal force and it cuts cleanly, leaving only a fine knob. So as for the design, it has a nice grip. It may be a bit small for you if you're like me, a big hand. So, and yeah, great pair. And for $24, 24 euros, it's a bargain. Next up, Games Workshop. The company everybody loves to hate. While I agree that some of their products are hit and miss, with pricing that oftentimes don't really make sense, they also have a lot of great value items. I love the design of these nippers, it's like steampunk industrial themed. So let's see how these cut. They actually cut very well and softly, leaving only just a very fine knob. And I mean, for the price, it's just 27 euros for something that can cut so cleanly and so well with just minimal force. So my only gripe with this nipper is the lack of grip support, because it's so slippery, sometimes it falls off of my hand when I pick it up. The large blades and the body will enable you to cut thicker sprues, you know, clear, especially those clear plastics. since they are harder, you know, better use a larger cutter. It's a really, really cool design and worth the price. Now this one looks really cool. It's like a Gundam by itself. And it's very affordable for 16 euros. The Bandai Spirits build-up nippers blades are made of high carbon steel. And it has this comfortable grip that also looks cool. So let's see how it cuts. It actually felt comfortable, requires just minimal pressure, and it only leaves a very fine knob, which is usually what we want to save time sanding. This is a great pair for the price, and also looks cool. Next up, Redgrass Games Precision Nippers. RGG, or Redgrass Games, is a French company making quality tools for miniature painting, and this nipper is one of their best. It cuts almost as buttery smooth, but oftentimes still leaves a fine knob, but sometimes none at all. But nonetheless, it doesn't cause any stress on the plastic. So I got the supply drop today. These are some hexagear and dino kits. I'm gonna use them actually for some diorama stuff for later. This is perhaps the only other nipper I have that has a very close feel and performance to the Godhand Ultimate Nipper 5.0. Comfortable grip and around the same size as the Tamiya in Godhand. It also has a great price considering the quality, and especially for people who live in Europe, pay less taxes than importing a Godhand, for example. Next up is the ultra-fine nipper for plastic models Kawasemi. This nipper is a special collaboration product by Hobby Japan and various cutlery magazines like Nikken Cutlery. I'm sure there are other brands that are also part of this collaboration, but I only know of those two companies. Those are the only two cited. And they say that the design, the ultra-fine single-edged blade, is reminiscent of a kingfisher's beak. So that's why it's shaped like this. While it seems to cut smoothly and softly, it does leave quite a sharp knob afterwards. However, it has these thin blades, so it's great for cutting in small corners of a sprue. You would still need to clean up the sharp knob though. It's not really big, but it's kind of sticking out, as you can see here. I did expect more considering the limited availability of this nipper, or perhaps I got a dud. I don't know. Tell me about your experience if you have the same. So next up is the Godhand tool SPN 120 Ultimate Nipper 5.0. Let's see how it cuts. As you can see here, it just flat out cuts like a hot knife through butter, with very little effort. And in the rare case that it leaves a knob, it's barely visible. So from everything I've tried so far, the Godhand is still, it still remains peerless amongst the competition. There's just nothing that cuts as buttery smooth and as cleanly as it. Of course, the quality comes with a price, so this is around 42 euros, plus shipping and taxes if you live outside of Japan. Now hold on a sec. I also have the variant of this nipper, which is specifically angled to reach those tiny corners in a sprue or gate. They're basically the same in terms of performance, except for the color and the size and angle of the blades. All right, so from everything I've tried so far, I still stand by my previous evaluation. The Godhand Ultimate Nipper 5.0 still remains peerless amongst the competition. I know it's pricey, but there's just nothing that cuts as buttery smooth and as cleanly. The reason why we want a nipper to cut as cleanly is to avoid the stress on the plastic. Some of the cheaper nippers, they just pinch and they stress the knobs and you have this ugly white discoloration. So if you aren't going to paint your kits, this will be very visible and it's gonna stick out like a sore thumb, and it will diminish the overall look of your models. Even if you intend to paint your model, cutting a sprue part cleanly means you might only have to do minimal sanding. So this really saves you time, because you'd be surprised at the amount of time you will be spending just cleaning and sanding off larger knobs from rough nipper cuts. As with everything else in life, you pay for quality and convenience. Of course, maybe not everyone could do that. So the best advice I could give you is just to buy the best that you can afford. It could be a $5 nipper or a $25 nipper. But if you're already spending money on kits, consider getting better quality tools, as this will save you a lot of time and it will make your building experience just more enjoyable rather than a daunting experience. And lastly, don't forget to have fun. There's nothing worse than stifling your own creativity by overthinking and constantly comparing yourself to others, especially those who've had more experience than you. So thanks again for watching, and I hope this gave you some insight on what kind of other nippers are available out there. As for the comparison, I'm only using the ones I actually own. See you guys next time. See ya!